XM2 Pursuit is the leader in the aviation industry as far as service providing. Together, we form basically a one-stop shop that provide any type of aerial services in the industry, from commercial TV shows and major feature films. We were lucky to be able to test the new 65-300 signature zoom. We put that 65-300 on our K1, and we flew through different scenarios and was mimicking high energy scenarios than we usually encounter doing feature film shoots. We shot with big parallax and compression through buildings in downtown LA. We did big wides and water rushes with very contrasted scenarios with a lot of highlights and glares in the water. And we kind of put that to the test to understand the full range of capability of the lens. We're impressed from the bokeh that the lens carry. It is a very soft and creamy. The texture of the lens is pretty remarkable, and the way they carry the highlights, it's really impressive. The fact that it's a magnesium chassis makes that lens very light. It's around 20 pounds. Comparable lens in Super 35, they can go up to 25 to 28 pounds, which make the signature zoom lens a better choice for us in the aero industry because we'll keep our total gross weight lower and allow us to be more nimble and flexible and to put that lens to a variety of projects that could require that full frame characteristic of that lens. John Tambura and myself, we operate as a unison inside of that aircraft, kind of caught the same interesting characteristic that this lens make the image look very creamy and very soft, which helped to cut down that digital look that we're used to nowadays in our digital world. Being feature film creatives, we work with people that likes to shoot on film because of exactly that type of softness that the film carry inherently. And I think the signature zoom is exactly that. We were able to shoot over the water with a very high contrast situation, and we never had that peaking type of effect that usually we have when we shoot in situation of high contrast light. Beautiful lens.